You probably think growing on Instagram nowadays requires posting 7 days a week, spending hours of perfecting your hooks, but that is actually no longer true. AI has completely transformed the Instagram content game, and most creators haven't even caught up yet. So in this video, I'm going to show you 4 AI tools that will revolutionize how you create content for Instagram forever. From hooks that actually stop the scroll, that are actually good hooks, because I know everybody's struggling with this whole thing, to content that consistently beats the algorithm without burning you out. Let's get into this whole thing. Now, the first tool is going to change the game for you, hopefully, and it is actually free. Yeah, actually free because I created it. I have the link in the description, and what it does is actually, it helps you create hooks that are 10 times better than your current ones. I've actually put in thousands of data points of hooks, psychological triggers, and just the free version that you can actually use right now, and it's honestly gonna be a game changer for some of you. So what you need to do is simply take your script, right? Obviously you need to write your script, your hooks, obviously, and or take a hook of a similar video in this hook generator helper. Easy as that. And what this whole thing does is it analyzes the hook that you wrote, and then it gives you suggestions for immediate improvements. So for example, let's take somebody who submitted their channel for our channel reviews here in our creator club newsletter, basically. And let's just actually take this random video right here. So what we're gonna do right now is I'm gonna watch this.
If there's one tip I can give you that makes fat loss way easier, it's to find satiating alternatives to foods you already enjoy. Take these Kinder Country overnight oats, for example. It's super easy to make, under 500 calories, nearly 40.
Okay, so see, it's already getting a little boring for me, but let's just take this hook right there and let's just paste it in there. Okay, so what I've done here is basically I used this, also AI, by the way. This is not one a real tip. But you can literally just go ahead, take any random video that you find on Instagram, use this button right here, and basically import it, and then it's gonna do transcriptions for you. Wow. So take that as another tip, I guess. But let's just come here to this hook analyzer and paste this whole script in there. You know, I just tell you, only paste in the hook, but let's just take it as it is right now. Cool. So the first thing it actually gives you is a hook score. Basically based off of my data points, right? Based off of me really analyzing a lot of hooks basically for this AI thing. And first of all, it gives you some of the strengths just so you understand what's going on. So the hook is actually, if there's one tip I can give you that makes fat loss way easier, this line does hint at a transformation. It taps into the strong desire for easier fat loss. But to crank up the scroll stopping power, lead with a pattern breaking insight or unexpected claim. For example, most people fail fat loss because of this one missing food switch, or fat loss doesn't need willpower, it needs this breakfast swap. Okay, interesting. This sharpens the curiosity gap, makes the viewer wonder what exactly the switch is, and raises tension that gets paid off in the next 2-3 seconds. Cool. I actually love it. Actually, let's do another round, because you know, sometimes you want to work with the AI. That's the most important thing. You don't just want to leave it there and take it as it is. You want to challenge the AI. Craving sweets, but still want to lose fat? Try this high protein swap. Awesome. I even love that. Obviously, it depends on your target audience, but it helps you also figure out what's going on here with this whole thing. And instantly, just using that on all of your videos going forward for totally for free, you can level up your hook game to get more views, because that's the most important thing. Now, what if you had just a B-roll type of video without actually speaking? Because I know you guys are going to say, damn, I don't speak in my videos. You should actually speak in your videos, but let's not even get into this whole thing. But I took another one, Poor Without Hella, who also submitted her channel as a review thing for the Creator Club newsletter, also for free, by the way. Let's just take a random one right here, this one. So what you could do here is either describe your first frame hook to the AI and say, okay, it's just a B-roll type of video without spoken words, or you can just literally screenshot this this thing, okay? Oh, YouTube algorithm. And once you screenshotted it, just put this in there and say something, for example, like B-roll video without spoken words, and just hit enter. So first of all, hook score. Well, Dominik would say this hook sucks, and I say the same. I didn't even look at it, man. So let me take a look at it, actually. Do I agree with this? Yeah, I can say this hook, I wouldn't say it sucks. It's actually okay. I would give it a 3 out of 10, which, obviously. So the strengths are it visually signals a unique twist, blueberry and coffee. So the AI actually picked that up, which is mildly intriguing. But if you've been watching my channel here for a while, you might know by this point, mildly intriguing doesn't cut it anymore, right? So it, yeah. So basically, what are some actionable improvement tips? To create a scroll-stopping curiosity gap, reframe the hook to tease the unexpected flavor combo and its taste reaction. You won't believe what blueberry does to iced coffee. Actually, not bad. Kind of sensationalist, but it's actually not bad. This flavor combo shouldn't work in coffee, but it slaps. I love this one. Actually, this one is awesome. Now, these versions trigger pattern interruption and make the viewers need to watch to validate this whole thing. I love it. Now, let's not even get into the first frame and stuff like this. We're going to make a whole nother video about the actual hooks and some new updated things. But just implementing this simple hook swap will actually do a lot of things and actually make things a lot better. And you're probably going to get more views instantly. Now, this next one is something I haven't fully utilized yet, but the possibilities are, again, insane. You might have noticed or actually heard from somewhere that carousels are crushing it right now, again, basically. And while I wouldn't recommend you to have a carousel-only strategy, it certainly can't hurt to create the one or the other carousel. But basically what it is, you can essentially use ChatGPT's image generation model to basically clone existing carousels. Now, first of all, don't completely clone carousels and steal things. Obviously, actually, right now, thinking about it, I shouldn't have even talked about this at all because I know some of you guys are just going to steal things because that's how you roll. But for example, if we go to Alex Hormozi, right? Find this interesting looking carousel right there. Basically, just copy and paste this whole thing, put it into ChatGPT and say, well, put my face on the statue on top and change the text to that. And here we go, you know. Basically, looks kind of not really like me, but then again, in a weird way, it does. Or here's another thing I made. I was just trying out some stuff. So for example, I was like, create me a cinematic and aesthetic Instagram carousel first image, blah, blah, blah. And it spit out this. Obviously, it doesn't look really good. So nothing really to hit home. Then I basically took a screenshot of something that looks cool. And I'm like, recreate this. What I said in a similar style to this. Guess what happened? It's a little skewed here, but it doesn't really look that good if you compare it with the one before. But it's there. What's shocking is it basically just recreated the face. So it didn't copy it, but recreate it. And then basically I started to play around with this a little more. I say, add more graphic and UI elements, make it clickable, swipeable for a very nice designed Instagram carousel. I know it's a very bad prompt, but I just wanted to see. It came up with something a little better. A little better, but it still doesn't hit the mark. So what I thought then was, what if we just take existing things that work that are not from creators, but from somewhere else, and just feed this to this AI? So for example, the old Apple commercials ads, right? The vintage ones. For example, this one, right? Because they're designed to actually hook people. So, you know, so basically I put this in there and say, create a cheeky ad that makes people want to know the best hooks to go viral in the style of old Apple ads. Guess what happened? This is actually pretty good. Once you go viral, learn the best hooks, think different. So obviously it's still not perfect. So the next thing I did was change the text to 101 hooks to go viral. And then below with a smaller font, how we got 571 million views, remove the Apple logo and replace it with the heyDominik logo. And instead of think different, right? Five frameworks to copy today. And I put in basically my face right there. Here's what happens. It kind of created a weird version of myself where that makes me look like I'm a hamster. That's not how I look in real life, okay? Okay. I know I look a little different in real life. That's what people always say. That's not me. But honestly, it's okay. You even created a logo for me, but still not good. And I said, recreate this ad with exactly the text from above. Change the image to a futuristic yet retro iPhone. And as you can see, honestly, it's getting there. So right now I've been kind of trying to use this framework, this API, to build a program for creative mentorship people that actually makes this be on steroids. But honestly, just playing around with that already is honestly pretty crazy. And you can get 80%, 90% of the work done in a very fast way, and then just tweak the rest of the things in Photoshop or wherever you want. Which gets me to the next point that has completely changed the game for me, and essentially cloning myself for various tasks that basically 100x my output. So for example, for my clients, I've built a bunch of things. First of all, a content research tool that helps them find ideas, pre-validated content, and we're currently developing this even further. So it actually spots patterns and gaps to take over most of the tedious work in terms of market research and all that crappy things that people usually hate. I also created something called the script architect, which is very similar to the free version of this hook thing, but it just goes so much deeper. People in the Korean Run Show actually love it. They're like, we can't live without this anymore, because it basically analyzes your scripts, helps you rewrite them to make them so much more interesting for your target audience, right? And you actually learn a lot from this as well. By the way, we also have a bot for this that helps creators define or redefine their avatars for this reason, so they understand, okay, what really keeps them up at night, and like how do you really extract this information from tons of data points. We also have one that lets you figure out and implement branding elements to make viewers really become interested in you, you know, basically to help you stand out and not be boring in a natural way, using primal branding principles and stuff like this. And I also use it, like I've been cloning myself a lot of times at this point already. I use it to help me write email campaigns, right? Landing pages, the text especially, thumbnails here for YouTube, content ideas. I have something called like a content waterfall system. I'll show you this at some point if you guys want. And right now, these things are literally just taking me 1 hour per week instead of 15, 20, probably 25 hours per week before I had this, right? And here's the thing, it's not just me telling AI, just do this, write me something, AI. No, that's not how it works. But it basically helps me, first of all, do so many things so much faster. It knows my style, it knows what my brain basically is about. Plus, it's like a second brain that acts like I would, right? And sometimes in a very scary way, even better, which is crazy. Sometimes not, by the way. Right? Which is why it's super important to be aware of the concepts and principles behind these things, and to actually understand when the AI potentially gives you some crappy answer, because that's actually what it does sometimes. Even my things a lot here, even the free one, it's going to give you some crap sometimes. Now, if you're interested actually in getting access to these things, you know, we're just building out a lot of them and we're constantly expanding this thing, including my whole training library, access to me and my team. We're actually launching something brand new pretty soon, the Creator Sprint, because, you know, depending on when you watch this, the Creator Mentorship is currently totally full, but we've created something equally as good. But you basically get access to these things, accountability, and basically a roadmap on how to actually use this to get results like these. Now, the fourth one is actually something that has the potential to basically make you never have to get out of bed again. You know, it's been around for a while, but recently it's gotten pretty good, if you ask me. We're talking about the ability to clone yourself, your video, and your voice, right? Now, I'm not saying that's the absolute end game, so I wouldn't recommend it to use it for full videos, even though you can, you know, especially if people don't expect it. You can totally pull this off. But I know how it's like, right? Sometimes you just don't really feel like it, right? Sometimes you have a video that's mostly B-roll or voiceover anyway. So you're like, I don't want to set up everything, you know? Or let's say you write the script, you film the video, and while editing suddenly, you have a ton of ideas on how to make this better. Or, you know, suddenly you're like, oh, this is another hook that I could use. And then you use the other hook for trial reels, for example. Stuff like this, been there 500 times probably. With HeyGen, which is, by the way, the software here, and it's not sponsored, by the way, it's pretty easy to not have to do that, right? And there's different ways. One of the new things, and again, it's not sponsored at all, is you can just put a picture of you in there and it turns yourself into a pretty okay-ish looking AI avatar with just one picture, right? And especially if it's just visible for a few seconds, you can totally pull this off. Same thing with your voice, by the way.
By the way, I am not real. It's all AI. My voice is kind of off, but I literally only played around with it for 5 minutes.
Now, honestly, thinking about this whole thing, it's pretty crazy, right? Thinking of where we've come from and especially how fast we've come to that point. And if you don't familiarize yourself with the whole AI train, you will be gone by this time next year. I can tell you that. Maybe I will even be gone because somebody cloned my brain, put me into a freezer. But with that being said, without understanding all the fundamentals of how the game actually works, how your audience works and stuff like this, you're not even going to know what to use these tools for, which is why I made this video here to break down the exact process that works currently right now to grow to 10,000 followers as fast as possible. It's actually so good, I'm going to take it down and charge for it, honestly. So be quick.